Brand Dr. Thomas Hind, July 10, 1737 September 28, 1828, was Northern Kentucky's first physician, a member of the British Royal Navy, an American Revolutionary, personal physician to Patrick Henry, and treated General Wolfe when he died in Quebec, Canada. Overview. Thomas Hind is the patriarch of the Hind family in the United States, and many of his children, grandchildren, and other descendants became prominent historical figures. His youngest son, Thomas S. Hind, was a notable Methodist minister and businessman. Charles T. Hind, his grandson, was a shipping magnate, and Edmund C. Hind, another grandson, was an adventurer. The Cavanaugh and Southgate branches of his family held elected office and positions of leadership in the Methodist Church. As personal physician to Patrick Henry, Hind played a critical role in the American Revolutionary War through his vaccinations against smallpox and treatment of wounded soldiers. For his service, he received a large land grant in Kentucky, where he moved with his family. Hind was Northern Kentucky's first physician, and a memorial was erected in Campbell County, Kentucky to honor his services to the state. He died in 1828, aged 91, which was unusually old for the time. According to Otto Jutner in 1909, who was a famous medical doctor and medical historian, Hind never wrote a line in his life. His life has been described as being like a romance, and he was called a patriarch to the American medical profession. Early life. Hind was born in Oxfordshire, England, in July 1737. He received a classical education in Oxfordshire and, after completing his studies, was sent to London, England to study medicine. He studied physics and surgery under Dr. Thomas Brooke at St. Thomas Hospital in London and, at the age of 19, was presented to the Company of Surgeons for a license. Shortly after, he was commissioned as a surgeon's mate in the Royal Navy and sailed for America with the forces commanded by General Amherst. After landing in New York on June 10, 1757, he spent time at Halifax and Louisbourg. Hind spent the winter of 1758 in Halifax and assisted Amherst with the reduction of Louisbourg. He was attached to the ship which bore the Commander-in-Chief, General James Wolfe, on his way to Quebec. Death of General Wolfe. Wolfe died in Hind's arms during the 1759 Battle of Quebec of the Seven Years' War. According to one source, Hind's relationship with General Wolfe and his experiences in Quebec were some of the most cherished experiences of his life. A painting of the death shows Dr. Hind compressing a wound to General Wolfe's torso. It is an oil on canvas of the Enlightenment period. Benjamin West, who painted it, made a nearly identical painting of the same scene for King George III in 1771. After Wolfe's death, Hind remained in the British Navy and was present for the reduction of Belle Isle. Shortly after, Hind was promoted and remained as a physician for a warship after the peace of 1763. He eventually resigned his commission. Copies of the Death of General Wolfe by West are currently in the collection of the National Gallery of Canada, the Royal Ontario Museum, Canadiana Art Collection, the William L. Clements Library at the University of Michigan and at Ickworth House, Suffolk, England. After Quebec. After the fall of Quebec, Hind returned briefly to England. Peace with France was reached in 1763, and Hind then returned to Virginia and settled. He formed a close friendship with an unnamed Virginian who persuaded him to settle in a place called Hobbs Hole in Essex County, Virginia, and practice medicine. Another source states that an aged physician in Virginia wrote to Dr. Thomas Brooke, Hind's mentor, asking Brooke to send a young physician to assist him in his practice. Brooke reportedly chose Hind and earnestly advised him to avail himself of the situation which was offered. Hind accepted, but moved soon after to settle in Newton, now in West Virginia, where he met his wife. After their wedding, Hind moved again and settled in Hanover County, Virginia. Physician to Patrick Henry. In 1765, after he settled in Virginia, Hind became acquainted with Patrick Henry, one of the founding fathers of the United States, Samuel Davis, and Lord Dunmore. 2 years later he married Mary T. Hubbard, settled near Henry, and became his family physician. His association with Henry and settlement in Virginia helped Hind become acquainted with many of the leading members of society during the period. When Hind first met Hubbard, he found her to possess a great flow of animal spirits, full of humor, gay and lively inner temperament and disposition, with strong powers of mind, and at the same time active and sociable. The couple married on September 24, 1767. According to a biography written by George Coles in 1857, Henry's statesmanlike eloquence and political principles made a strong impression on Hind and shifted him from being a staunch royalist to a sturdy republican. Hind took an active part in the American Revolutionary War, serving as a surgeon with Patrick and in various campaigns and battles. At the time of the 1775 gunpowder incident, Hind was chief surgeon for Patrick Henry. His involvement in it was the turning point that led him to embrace the cause of the oppressed colonies against Lord Dunmore and the English royalty. The gunpowder incident was a conflict early in the American Revolutionary War, between Lord Dunmore, the royal governor of the colony of Virginia, and militia led by Henry. Hind originally planned to take a frontline post in Henry's regiment, but when Henry was elected governor, Hind was instead appointed to inoculate all members of the Continental Service. Because of insufficient funds in the Continental Army, Hind was forced to cover the costs of inoculations, which seriously impaired his private fortune. One source states that Hind amputated limbs during the war by the cartload. After the war, Hind continued to live in Hanover County for many years, primarily practicing medicine. Military land grant. After the American Revolutionary War, Hind moved his family from Virginia to Kentucky, having received a large land grant for his services in the war. One source describes the land grant as follows. At the close of the war, having drawn no part of his salary, and from his great skill as a surgeon having endeared himself to the Virginians, in settling up his accounts he was presented with a land warrant, to be located in lands selected in Kentucky, leaving a blank within the warrant for the number of acres to filled by Dr. Hind himself. The blank was filled with 20,000, and placed in the hands of Patrick Henry to select and locate the lands. For undisclosed reasons, Henry was unable to complete the land grant to Hind due to surveying difficulties, who then used his nephew Hubbard Taylor to go to Kentucky, find the location, and complete the transaction. Hind gave Taylor half of the lands for this service. The land was in Clark County, Kentucky, between Winchester and Lexington. Conversion to Methodism. During his early years in England, Hind was a member of the Church of England, but he abandoned the church as an adult and had become a deist. One biographer stated that for a time Hind took pride and pleasure in ridiculing Christianity. In later years, however, his religious views underwent a radical change. In 1798, Methodist ministers arrived in Hind's neighborhood and began to convert people. Susanna, one of Hind's daughters, converted, causing distress to the family. Hind banished her from his home, and she went to live with her aunt 40 miles away. However, this failed because the aunt had already converted, and Hind's wife converted soon after. Hind became convinced that the disorder was in their heads, and treated them with medical procedures of the day, such as a blistering plaster to the whole length of the spine, which he left on for several days. Drake states that, through this measure of violence, he hoped to deter her from further attendance at places of public worship. The procedures were painful, but his wife stated afterwards that it was a punishment, but I never was so happy in all my life. Hind later felt guilt for having banished his daughter and performed medical operations on his wife, and he converted to Methodism. His daughter returned home and his wife began attending Methodist gatherings regularly. Two of his daughters married traveling preachers, and another daughter converted to Methodism too. By the end of his life, Hind was a devout Methodist. According to one account, at another time he was taking a morning walk and met General James Taylor, a relative by marriage, who said, "Good morning, doctor, where are you going?" "I am going to heaven, where are you going, General?" The general, at that time, had some doubts about whether his road led to the same country, and made no reply, but it is hoped he found the way to everlasting life before he left the world. One of Hind's grandchildren states that Hind built little houses of sticks and wood where he would pray. The grandchildren called them Grandpa's prayer houses. Hind could be heard praying from a considerable distance. Family. Hind married Mary Todd Hubbard, the daughter of Benjamin Hubbard, an English merchant, and they were married for 61 years. They had 8 children that lived to adulthood. His daughter Anne Winston Hind married Richard Southgate on July 30, 1799, in Newport, Kentucky. Hind and his family were members of the Grace Methodist Episcopal Church in Newport, Kentucky. One of Hind's sons was Thomas S. Hind, who was a co-founder of Mount Carmel, Illinois, and became a well-respected Methodist minister. Hind's grandson Captain Charles T. Hind was a successful businessman and riverboat captain. Charles was one of the principal investors in the Hotel del Coronado in San Diego, California, and inspired Frederick Hind Zimmerman, Dr. Hind's great-grandson, to build the Grand Rapids Hotel in Mount Carmel, Illinois. In his later life, Hind lived with his daughter Mary McKinney of Newport, Kentucky.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.